We have been fishing the ocean beyond and above what the ocean can give us, and very quickly we are running out of marine fishery species in our ocean.
In this building off Pratt Street in Baltimore, research is changing how the world consumes seafood.
Obviously, we go to the ocean to harvest our fish. Don't forget, we have to remember that fish actually are the last hunt and gather animal crop. You don't go to the wild to harvest your cattle or your chicken or your pigs, but you go, you do it for fish. And as a result, we became very efficient fishers, and we are very effectively emptying our ocean. So this has to change. And seafood or fish must be produced via agriculture, which is like any other crop. Like in our case, it's aquaculture.
The Institute of Marine and Environmental Technology, known as IMET, leads critical scientific research as our human population rises while fish stocks decline. The U.S. has a huge seafood trade deficit, meaning our country is importing more seafood than exporting. IMET is part of the University System of Maryland and has a mission of studying, protecting, and enhancing marine resources across the globe.
Over 90% of the marine fisheries species are either overfished, so they are on a major decline, or fully fished beyond sustainable level.
Dr. Jonathan Zohar oversees research toward a solution. He's a professor of marine biotechnology and the director of the Aquaculture Research Center, known as the ARC, located in the lower level of IMET. You can think of aquaculture as relief for the ocean.
Aquaculture is totally the same as agriculture, only for marine and aquatic organisms.
Scientists are figuring out the best ways to farm fish. Dr. Zohar says aquaculture production will have to double by 2040 to keep up with the demand.
The major aquaculture platform that we are using right now are floating net pens in the marine, mostly coastal environment.
Instead of floating net pens, the ARC grows fish in land-based tanks. These are called recirculating aquaculture systems, or RAS. They don't need to be on the coastline.
Those floating net pens have an adverse effect on the environment in terms of like runoffs and nutrients going into the marine environment, but also there is this problem of SKPs. You know, farmed fish are different from wild fish, and salmon in a net pen is different from salmon in the wild. And when it escapes, it has a biological impact on your wild salmon population.
Dr. Zohar says salmon is the U.S. consumer preference for eating fish. He leads a research hub funded by a $10 million USDA grant. The hub's program seeks to enable and expand RAS technology for land-based salmon in the U.S.
Our main objective is to identify the main bottlenecks to the development of land-based Atlantic salmon aquaculture production and conduct research, collaborative research. So collaboration is a very key word for our research, and conduct research that is going to enable the opening of those bottlenecks, overcoming the hurdles, so the industry can be more efficient, cost-effective, and beneficial, you know, to the stakeholder.
Researchers listen to stakeholders in the aquaculture industry to select the most important research topics. Dr. Zohar emphasizes that this is an industry-driven project. One bottleneck is egg production.
Right now, the entire salmon industry brings eggs from overseas, from Europe, to start the production. This is not going to be allowed for a long time because of regulatory aspect. You can introduce a disease. It's not always reliable, and so on. So we are developing program for and technologies to produce salmon eggs from North American strains of Atlantic salmon.
The ARC is developing technology to produce salmon eggs in the U.S. all year round. Another challenge is early maturation of fish. When fish reach sexual maturation, their growth rate slows as they put all their energy into developing their eggs. This is a big problem for the industry.
The entire industry is looking for a technology to generate reproductively infertile fish.
Dr. Zohar says his team is very close to accomplishing this and making the technology available to the industry.
We are using insect meal proteins.
They are also developing new fish feed because feed accounts for a large portion of the budget in aquaculture.
We are developing alternative feeds that are more environmentally responsible, that are deprived of the marine ingredient, that are deprived of fish meal and fish oil.
They have perfected water recycling and reuse technology and are working to find uses for waste produced by fish in the tanks.
So this is the same water that recycles for months and months. We do not replace the water here.
At the ARC, laboratory technicians mix Baltimore City water with salts to mimic natural conditions in the ocean. They are also investigating the role of tiny beneficial bacteria in removing fish waste and maintaining healthy conditions for fish.
So this is a biofilter. One of the biofilters that remove the chemical waste, the dissolved chemical waste produced by the fish. This macaroni here is just a plastic substrate that provides a lot of surface for the beneficial bacteria to settle on.
While trying to keep waste from going out to the environment, IMET's team produced biofuel, which can be used to offset some of the energy costs of an aquaculture operation.
We went to the ocean and we identified marine bacteria that are consuming the sludge and the solid waste, organic waste, and in so doing they convert it totally to fuel grade methane, to biogas, to biofuel.
In another research project contracted by an aquaculture company, Dr. Zohar's team is working to determine the best growing environment for the fish in the culture tanks.
Beautiful salmon. You can notice right away that the light is a little bit different. So these tanks, and the reason that the lids are closed here, are part of a large experiment where we are testing different types of light spectra and intensities on the performance of the fish.
The ARC's prominence in aquaculture research expands beyond salmon. Given IMET's location, the Chesapeake Bay is a priority, and ARC researchers have studied blue crabs and striped bass for years, including their diseases and ways to enhance their stock.
But the big problem is that the spawning stock has been on a major decline, and this was a stock replenishment of the spawning stocks. So we have been working for many, many years on that, and we were the only place in the world that was able to close the life cycle of the blue crab and develop hatchery-produced crab and scale it up even.
Zebrafish are not a bay species, but you can find them in labs worldwide. They are an important model species, not only in aquaculture science, but also in biomedical research. The ARC's sophisticated zebrafish labs are hotspots for cutting-edge research.
Some of our scientists are studying mechanism involved in muscle development, skeletal development, muscle diseases, and so on. And zebrafish is an excellent model for studying all those aspects.
The ongoing research happening at IMET is helping to ensure we don't run out of fish to feed the world.
Not only there are more people on the planet, but more people eat more fish. All the research that we do has the goal of enabling and advancing the industry.